2023 has been an exciting year in the computer chip business. Apple, Intel, and Qualcomm have all brought some cool new products to market, setting the stage for a new era in PC technology. But let's be real, deciphering the differences between Apple's M3, Intel's 14th gen, and Qualcomm's Snapdragon X Elite can feel like navigating a maze of tech jargon. Don't stress though, this video will break it down for you. We're gonna dive into the nitty-gritty of these new chips, lay out their unique superpowers, and spill the tea on what they mean for the future of the tech scene. Get ready for a tech talk that won't make your head spin.
Are you struggling to explain your idea? Your audience is not getting what you're trying to say. An animated explainer video is a perfect solution for you. Explainer video simplifies any complex ideas through engaging animations, transitions, voiceovers, and meaningful scripts, which all together create a fun experience for any viewer. And here comes 10 Studio, a team of skilled professionals dedicated to creating engaging explainer videos. With over thousands completed projects, we have the expertise to create explainer videos that break down your message and connect with your audience. Get in touch with 10 Studio today.
Apple steps into the spotlight with the M3, giving its iMac a power-packed facelift. The M3 flaunts an 8-core CPU, a 10-core GPU, and a 16-core neural engine, all thanks to the 3-nanometer process. It's not just a cosmetic upgrade. We're talking 2x faster performance, 30% quicker app loading, 50% speedier gaming, and a Photoshop boost that'll make your jaw drop. And let's not forget the promise of a visual feast for hardcore gamers, with hardware-accelerated ray tracing. Moreover, efficiency cores hustle 15% faster, handling multi-threaded tasks with half the power. While design tweaks are minimal in M3, the performance leap makes it a tantalizing upgrade, especially for prosumer-focused tasks and gaming. Intel counters Apple's M3 dominance with a 14th-gen Meteor Lake. While it might not be a total game changer, it's a trailblazer in using a tiled architecture. This means it smoothly combines different core types, the high performance and the low power ones, finding that sweet spot between power and efficiency. This cool architecture, paired with Forever's fancy 3D packaging, makes things more efficient and amps up graphics performance. Intel also added a new feature to its extreme tuning utility called AI Assist, which offers AI-guided overclocking on select unlocked 14th-gen processors. Pat Gelsinger, Intel's chief, sees the AI PC as a pivotal moment, echoing the game-changing impact of Centrino in 2003. Despite rumors of a price hike, Intel is keeping their retail prices steady. The Core Ultra on Intel 4 is already in the hands of some customers, and the official launch is set for December 14th, right alongside the drop of their 5th-gen Xeon. Arrow Lake and Lunar Lake are Intel's next-gen promises, boasting ultra-low power mobility and breakthrough performance per watt, shaping the future of Intel's chip prowess. Meanwhile, Qualcomm enters the ring with the Snapdragon X Elite, a heavyweight in the generative AI PC market. If you've been following Qualcomm's attempt to challenge Intel in the PC world, you might doubt their success. Over 10 years ago, Qualcomm teamed up with Microsoft to create devices running Windows RT for PCs. But that venture didn't exactly stand the test of time. They tried Snapdragon chips in 2-in-1 laptops, initially designed for smartphones. Then in 2018, Qualcomm introduced its first PC CPU, with dreams of people rushing to grab PCs with 5G networking in 2019. However, despite these efforts, Qualcomm's chips hadn't made a significant dent in Intel's dominance. Qualcomm's journey into PCs has seen its fair share of twists, but the X Elite, born from the minds of ex-Apple engineers, guarantees an intense face-off with Apple and Intel. This time, the company promises the X Elite is the most powerful, intelligent, and efficient processor in its class for Windows. They also claim the new silicon will be around 68% more energy efficient than some of its direct competitors on the market. Qualcomm CEO Cristiano Amon boldly declared, "It's the fastest CPU for a laptop, period." That's a direct challenge to Apple, AMD, and Intel. The Snapdragon X Elite is aiming high, outperforming Apple's M2 Max chip in single-threaded performance while consuming 30% less power consumption. Initial specs suggest it's twice as powerful as certain Intel counterparts, making it a top pick for heavy-duty tasks like 4K video editing. This news might be the reason people are eagerly looking for laptops with the X Elite, set to hit the market around mid-2024. Now let's talk about how the new chips impact our gaming experience. Apple's M3 Max is the new star, stealing the spotlight in both single and multi-core testing. It poses a real challenge to traditional gaming laptops rocking Intel processors. In games like Shadow of the Tomb Raider, Baldur's Gate 3, and Lies of P, the M3 Max achieves gaming performance previously unseen in MacBooks. On the flip side, Qualcomm's X Elite doesn't quite steal the show in this category. Nevertheless, the senior vice president and general manager of computing and gaming at Qualcomm, Keter Kondam, wants us to think beyond hardcore gaming. He points out that modern consumers are often into creating and casual gaming. The X Elite powered laptops are designed to meet diverse needs, even if they're not the go-to for heavy-duty photo or video editing. While the chip's integrated GPU may not meet the demands of hardcore gaming, Qualcomm aims to enhance the gaming experience with better colors and performance. The tech world is about to change with AI becoming a big deal in computers. By 2024 and 2025, Windows is getting an upgrade, and apps will be infused with advanced AI on every chip. This means better efficiency, faster results, and cool new things like Microsoft's Copilot. In Apple's corner, the M3-based Macs are stepping up with a 60% boost in ML model performance with an enhanced neural engine. This not only speeds up AI and ML workflows, but also reinforces Apple's commitment to user data privacy. Intel is bringing AI to consumer PCs by the end of the year through its new Meteor Lake chips, as confirmed by Intel executives during this year's Hot Chips conference at Stanford University. Meteor Lake chips will be able to make use of AI to manage power and the transition between active and low power states, as per information shared by PC World. The 14th-gen Raptor Lake refresh processors promise enhanced gaming and AI-guided overclocking. Meanwhile, Qualcomm is making bold promises with efficient handling of 7 billion parameter LLMs, unlocking lightning-fast AI responses and delivering advanced multitasking experiences with minimal latency. But Qualcomm's ace in the hole is adding generative AI on-device that can process everything locally. This means users can get questions answered, stories written, and images generated without relying on the cloud. Moreover, the X Elite's neural processing unit proved 3 times faster at running tasks in Blackmagic's DaVinci Resolve Studio software. Qualcomm aligns with industry leaders like Apple and Google in recognizing the benefits of on-device AI. They emphasize the advantages of enhanced privacy protection and faster processing without relying on cloud services. While some AI tasks may still require cloud computing, the trend is shifting toward hybrid local and cloud setups for more intensive AI operations. Now developers have choices, as the X Elite supports 20 AI models and rocks a staggering 45 trillion operations per second. The battle for CPUs and GPUs that handle AI tasks well is in full swing. It's hard to confidently say right now who is surpassing who in this sector. Apple is already selling M3-powered MacBooks, while Qualcomm is essentially selling a promise. And there's still the challenge of poor Windows on ARM optimization and the tough task of convincing developers to shift away from x86. Microsoft has been trying for over a decade to make Windows on ARM a viable alternative, but they haven't quite got it off the ground yet. So excuse us if we're not overly optimistic with the X Elite about this one. Windows laptop users face a dilemma. Will they lean towards PCs with Qualcomm processors because of the promises made by Snapdragon X Elite? Avi Greengart sees Qualcomm's leap in performance per watt as a potential threat to Intel. However, despite benchmarks checking out, real-world implementations could sway the verdict. The problem with Qualcomm's new chips is that they aren't in any devices yet. So even if Qualcomm flaunts impressive benchmark charts, Apple's chips are already in devices that people are using today. People are experiencing real-world benefits, something I don't think we'll see with Qualcomm chips until Windows catches up in the ARM software conversation department. Qualcomm isn't exactly outpacing anyone, and Windows is pretty late to the ARM game. Whether or not the Snapdragon X Elite revolutionizes the PC market, its impact will ripple across Qualcomm's entire lineup, from mobile to auto to XR and beyond. And it looks like the real face-off for chip supremacy seems to boil down to Apple versus Qualcomm, a stark contrast to a decade ago when Intel and AMD ruled the chip battleground. The shift from x86 to ARM architecture, initiated by Apple, poses a challenge to Intel's traditional stronghold. Apple became successful, and their success gave hope to Qualcomm. Qualcomm, even a generation behind, their advancement shows that Apple's tech isn't alone in this race, and catching up is within reach. The worry is not for Apple, but for Intel, facing not one, but two new challenges in a market it once dominated alone. Losing Apple as a customer is a setback in itself. But Apple's chips were only used in Apple products and didn't threaten Intel's larger market of Windows PCs. Now, with other chips appearing in Windows PCs, starting with Qualcomm, Intel is in big trouble. Apple won't be losing the lead anytime soon. While it's commendable that Qualcomm is making such chips, it doesn't mean much when Windows isn't optimized for them yet. We've seen benchmark results, and it only outperforms the base M3, looking to both the Pro M3 and Max M3. And we haven't even seen the Ultra variant yet, which is expected to be a powerhouse. Plus, for Qualcomm to win in single-core performance, it had to be pushed to 80 watts, and even then, it barely came out on top. Competition is great, but others have a long way to go to catch up with where Apple is, especially in terms of efficiency. Anticipated future rivals will probably only inspire Apple to further elevate its silicon chips. As rivals aim to catch up, Apple will already be knocking at their door with something even more advanced. Only time will reveal who emerges as the true champion in the chip war.